What is up, YouTube? This is ShadowSun232. Welcome to a tutorial on how to set up your Pokemon 3D client and server. I'm going to go over where to download it, what to set up, and everything. So what you would want to do is you would want to go to Pokemon3D.net. I already did a Google search on it, and go to Downloads. And once you hit Downloads page from, if you want to just Google the homepage, you can, and just click Downloads, but once you get to the Downloads page, you'd want this launcher right here, the 2.2.0.0. Make sure you check the MD5 and everything, make sure it's legit, which more than likely it is, because, yeah, it's something like that. But anyway, server, this is where you get the server as well, in case you want to, like, I don't know, do the, do your own server or whatnot. Requirements for both are the XNA Framework 4.0, which the launcher will prompt you to download, as well as NET Framework 4.5, which again, it'll prompt you to download. After you get them downloaded, because I already downloaded them, I put them in a Pokemon 3D folder. It's better to have them in a 3D, in a folder, separate folder, but I put them in both in the same folder, just for my convenience. Once you start, we'll start with the server. Once you start up the server, you'll get these DAT files right here. Let me sort these out. I want to sort them by name, actually. Sort by... modified, there we go. Basically, you'll get these four DATs right here. You want to go into Properties Data, DAT with Notepad. That's my public IP server. If you want to join my server, you can. But for now, you want to set all these up here. You want to put in your public IP, like mine's this up IP right here. You want to put your server name. Max players, I set to 50 just in case. I don't know if my computer can handle it, but we'll see. Offline mode, that's a big one. It makes you have to make people either use an online save through gamejolt, or if you want to use an offline save. Me, I'm indifferent about it. I prefer to use offline mode, but if you guys want to use online mode, you might be better off doing that. Server message, I haven't tinkered with. Don't tinker with weather or season, time offset, time preset, stuff like that. You can set the idle kick time to however many seconds you want to people to be on the server before and away from keyboard, you know, before they get kicked. Welcome message. And you can allow OPs. Basically, you can allow several people to kick, op other people, stuff like that. Don't save. That brings us to the OPs.dat. If you want to put people like me or my friend Quar onto the OP list, basically you either put them in this list or you type /OP in-game. I haven't tinkered around with the blacklist or whitelist or mute list yet, but we'll see what that happens. Anyway, once you got that up and running, start the server and everything, it'll start up with these messages right here, and you're pretty much done with the server. Now, for Pokemon 3D Client, you would want to launch the launcher, and it'll prompt you to download the latest version. I already have the latest version, so let's just start it up. And I'll switch to game mode. Hold on one sec. There we go. Basically, what we did was, you can either log into GameJolt like I'm going to do and play online. You have to have a save file either way before you can join a server. So after you select it, you can either select a server such as the Shadow Sun server that I'm going to select. And to add a server, you just click Add, name your server, and put the address in there. So let's see, I'm going to just do a demonstration here. I got my IP address here, so let's remove my server for a minute. Click Add, name your server, basically press Y to edit, doesn't mean anything, you can just start typing in that area. S-H-A-D-O-W-S-U-N-S-E-R-V-E-R. Now the address you would want to get, I have my address right here. So what we want to do is 76.115.47.238. It'll automatically put the port number in for you, so you don't have to worry about that. It'll pull it and pull it up for you. There you go. There you have it. That's how you set up a server. And also, if you want to join the server, you can. Leave a comment, rate, subscribe, stuff like that. I'll be doing a video on basically how to play, basically on the gameplay and stuff like that. So, again, leave a comment, subscribe, all the jazz. Catch you guys later.